Okay, we're back. John Fortine and Donovan Sabeek. We're going to talk about local politics and what's going on. A lot of stuff going on, a lot of stuff missing. It is election season. For Congress, I am still working on the candidates, and my first candidate that I'm going to be overviewing will be congressional candidate Aja Smith. Got a lot of feedback and information with her, and I will be getting some more information. When that is ready, we will let you guys know. But in the city of Moreno Valley, idiot Mayor Gutierrez has yet to appoint a planning commission. Sean, what do you got?
That's basically, last I heard, there was lull, and that was it.
They didn't have enough for a quorum last week, I heard.
Yeah, that's the thing. They didn't have enough of a quorum to decide, to handle city business.
Mm-hmm. And this has been going on for since August.
At least since the beginning of last year, I think.
When they tried to get Raphael on the committee.
Yeah, right after Gutierrez was sworn in, they started having those problems with trying to nominate
and get people on there.
Planning commissioner. And we had, at least Lowell had the credentials to be on there. So
former chairman and, you know, somebody that took care of Highland Fairview money, very tainted official, but he had experience.
As far as his education credentials, he's qualified for it. But Rafael Burgueras, I don't know.
I don't think he's a high school graduate.
But I don't think his literacy is up to par.
Yeah, you know, he's somebody I know. He's a nice guy, but his politics are a little bit wrong. I think he would just be a yes man for Ito.
I think that's why Gutierrez wanted him in the first place.
Right, he's just going to rubber stamp.
Gutierrez, that's basically how most of the Gutierrez's nominations were, is people that would just suck up to him.
Yeah, just suck up to him.
It's not a matter
just
of knowing what they're doing and thinking independently. It's just sucking up to Gutierrez.
Right,
just
which
like
is
Gutierrez kicked Gaiba off a bunch of commissions. Because Gaiba disagreed with Gutierrez's vision in the first place. And I'm quoting Gutierrez on that. I'm not making that up. That's on public record.
Right, exactly. And my question with if our city planning commission hasn't been effective in about 8 months,
that means business.
How are we supposed to be conducting city business here? Well, so who's conducting the city
business?
That
means that the growth of the economy and the growth of new businesses in the city is stalled until they can actually get business.
So for eight months, nothing's been approved in the city of Moreno Valley?
Not that I'm aware of. Well, except for I guess it wouldn't have to go through the city planning commission to put a warehouse in the Prologis.
That was already pre-approved.
Yeah, the paper company has announced they're moving in, but wasn't through the planning commission. So any business or economic activity that has to go through the planning commission is stalled, is a lot of it in any given city.
Right. I think Mr. Lee is the guy that brings in the businesses and go gets the businesses. And I'm kind of disappointed. I know Mr. Lee is a nice man and everything, but, you know, here once again is another person who doesn't live in the city of Moreno Valley, and he keeps bringing us these shit jobs. In the words of Trump, these shithole jobs. So that's what we're going to get. As long as we keep getting people, we should make a ordinance that says, if you're going to be working for the city of Moreno Valley, you must live in the city of Moreno Valley.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, especially city directors, you know, and staff.
Yeah. I mean, if they're like, use a homeless problem, for example, mm-hmm. it's like, I would like to have someone that like lives here and sees it on a daily basis and not just like a couple people on their way to work.
Right, I see somebody in the median asking for food.
Yeah, like that's probably why what's her name?
So sad.
The one that was just fired.
Yeah, Michelle Dawson.
Yeah, Michelle Dawson. That's probably why she only thinks there's 31 homeless people in the city.
Right. Yeah, she's coming off Alessandro into the
the
job.
Off the 215.
Yeah, the 215. Right.
Yeah, you can find 31 people on just that.
Exactly. Skechers. Skechers is having some difficulties we've been hearing about.
Seems to be a pattern there.
Yeah, I mean, you were saying that them and Highland Fairview are having a row.
Yeah.
And as we know, Highland Fairview could not complete the construction on the original Skechers
building when it initially happened by themselves. So they had to go into a special agreement to finish the build and get it available. And so I believe the build made Skechers the tenant or the owner. I think Skechers is the owner of the building.
Yeah, and then and there was also a bunch of liens against Highland Fairview.
Highland Fairview and things like that. So, and I heard, so I guess it's been almost, what, 10 years? 7, 8 years since it opened?
Yeah, like 8 or 9.
8 or 9 years. So in California, you can only do a contract to 7 years. Mm-hmm. So I wouldn't doubt if maybe that lease or whatever it might be up and they're going through a negotiation process.
Yeah.
You know?
I don't see how the World Logistics Center is going to grow if Udo keeps promising a phase 2 and 3
and
they're
doesn't
having
happen.
Trouble just renewing the lease on phase 1.
And I heard that they put a restaurant in there. It's supposed to be the best eats in Moreno Valley. Let me ask you this, Sean. If you're hungry and you have your family with you, you know, your friends or whatever, are you guys going to go to the Skechers warehouse to go have some of the best food ever? Is that supposed to attract
me to buy
tennis shoes?
I'm not going to drive from any other place in the city out to the remote area by Theodore Street with a bunch of grouchy kids.
But they say that it's supposed to be the best eating in Moreno Valley. Now, my question...
You know what, realistically, the best eating in Moreno Valley is usually spots that you don't notice. It's usually like the little hole-in-the-wall Mexican places that you wouldn't think about or like... It's usually places that are like tucked away in like
You don't even notice it.
Shop in a shopping center that you would never notice. Those are usually the best places.
The best places to eat. But it seems to me when they start doing this stuff, that shows a sign that there's something going on there. Because that little shoe store that they have in there, where you can purchase shoes at the Skechers place, I heard. I've never been in there. But what I'm hearing is they're not getting the business that they're getting. And it's, you know, I have a business degree. If you're not getting the sales monthly that you're supposed to do, there's no justification in keeping something like that open because you're actually losing money.
Yeah.
So,
and at best, Highland Fairview would have to significantly reduce the price on their lease if they want to keep them.
Right, they want to keep that thing and to keep that little shop there. And but by bringing a restaurant in there, I don't see how that's going to.
I don't even know how a lot of those workers would be able to afford to eat the restaurant if they're even if they're there. The workers are there. I still don't know how they how that would help them any more than. They'd probably still be brown bagging their lunch at the kind of prices that people pay
you know,
in Moreno Valley.
You know, labor. And I go on the east side sometimes, and when I have to go to the – a lot of people don't know this. You could really get some good food at the hospital cafeteria, you know, at a really nice price, you know, fair price to eat. So, you know, sometimes I'll stop over there wherever I'm doing if I'm in that area because my doctor's near in that area. But I would never go to I would never even fathom thinking of going to a warehouse and say, hey, let's go in here. You know what? I don't see that. Even when I drive the 215, I don't see a sign that says BB's restaurant. I don't see, you know, I wouldn't know there's a restaurant in there. I'd just be like, oh, there's another warehouse, you know? So
yeah,
that's something new. So I hope that works out. But then again, it goes to show you Highland Fairview. Once again, they have a track record of failure. They just do.
30 years of,
nothing.
Yeah, nothing. In Moreno Valley, 30 years of nothing, well, except for Skechers now, and Skechers isn't working out so well for him.
It isn't working out well. He formed something with his brother.
That's like epic train wreck, and that's actually significantly damaging Tulare's economy now because they couldn't keep the hospital running, and now all the well-paid doctors, nurses, equipment technicians, all
and the insured people that went there.
Yeah, there's no, they're not coming there and like spending their lunch money there. They're not shopping there. It's they're only getting a fraction of the business that they used to before Udo and Benny came to town.
Right. I mean, what's the definition of insanity? Doing the same thing over and over again, expecting a different result. And that's what we're getting here. Oh, Ito's going to do this. Ito's going to do this. There was an article in the...
Ito's been promising that he's going to do things for the last 30 years.
30 years. There was an article in the Press Enterprise where they were talking about the Aquabella project that did not come to fruition because last week there was a court case in regards to the WLC. I didn't get the disposition of that court case, but I will and give everybody an update on that. But that shows you that these lawsuits are still in motion, and a lot of people are getting tired of the lawsuits, and people are settling and getting their money and going about their business. But this guy is just, I mean, it was in the Press Enterprise, and they're saying that, you know, this guy, I mean, we have the infrastructure for a medical corridor if we wanted to do that. But
I wouldn't, but after that little fiasco, or not so little fiasco with Ito and Bengi, I wouldn't recommend having them
run a hospital or even be a part of it, any part of it, I think that would be a bad idea. But we have the infrastructure to do that, and this guy blocks everything that comes up that is the benefit of the community. And once again, I have to ask everybody that listens to this show and everybody that watches the show, how can you live in a community and let a person who doesn't live in the community call all the shots? And it's so sad that the Edowitz are so stupid. And it shows you how stupid the Edowitz are. You have a bunch of them that actually think Ito lives here. Millionaires do not live in Moreno Valley.
He lives on the other side of
Right, which is not Moreno Valley. It is county property. So he lives in the county part of it. He doesn't live in the city of Moreno Valley. That's why he can't vote here. Simple as that. And again, millionaires do not live in the city of Moreno Valley. So let's not overthink this, people. Use your common sense. Name me one millionaire that lives in the city of Moreno Valley.
There's none I can actually... There's a couple that might be millionaires, but I can't say that for a fact,
right.
So I can't name them.
Exactly. So, and the same thing with me. I can't name it for a fact, but I don't understand why people are okay with somebody who doesn't live in their community making the decisions and controlling their community. That's asinine. It's different if Ito lived here. I'd be like, well, he has a business here. He doesn't live here.
He's also not a citizen, so he still can't vote.
Right, exactly. And then, people say, it's like churches. Just because the church is here doesn't mean the pastor has the right to, have a comment on our politics. Because number one, he's not paying taxes for his church. And I don't have a problem with that. But that's the price you pay. If you want a church, you don't have to pay taxes. That means stay out of the politics. And there's nothing wrong with that. But I have a problem when a person doesn't live in my community and he's the person we have to go to deal with the local situation. Again, for those... Just a quick reminder, Saturday, 1 to 2:30 p.m., Moreno Valley Golf Course, we are having an emergency meeting about the project that's going on over there, the apartments that are going over there. The Edowitz are putting out false narratives. It is totally not true. Eric, the owner of that project, the guy, the developer that's doing that project, he will be there to answer any of your questions and dispel a lot of these rumors. Rumor number one, don't believe the hype. Eric and his company have not given one dime to the politics here in Moreno Valley. And that's a fact, because if it was, I would tell you. So
So basically, if it does not involve putting a building on the Highland Fairview property, there's going to be an organized group of people screaming against it.
Right, exactly. And what's come up, and since we're talking about local politics, is a lot of people have come up and they're wondering who is behind the recall of Victoria Baca. And the Edowitz keep saying that it's Eric and his company that is behind that recall. Now, if you watched my show and you've listened to the show, we have dispelled and we've told you basically who is behind the recall. And who's behind that recall is the same people who were behind the recall the first time. That would be the Democratic Club of Moreno Valley, controlled by Ray Dean Ayers. It's the same people. Thus, a recall was given on Dave Marquez. Why would a recall be given on Dave Marquez? Dave Marquez is a member of the Democratic Club of Moreno Valley, which is controlled by Ray Dean Ayers. And Ray Dean Ayers cannot be elected to dog catcher. Her daughter can't be elected to anything. Ray Dean Ayers was supposed to have retired from politics, but these people can't give it up and they can't go away. And after 30 plus years of being in politics in Moreno Valley, this is what Ray Dean Ayers has done. She has helped bring warehouses. We've lost our racetrack. We've got a failed mall, no youth center, no really legal accomplishments. And one of her last accomplishments was getting a bank robber elected to District 1. I think I said it pretty much all in a nutshell there.
Yeah.
So again, Saturday, 1 to 2:30 p.m., we will be there to cover it. If you can't make it, we're going to try to get this up on Facebook and get the information out. By the way, I have been put into Facebook jail several times by the Edoites. And it's really unfortunate because all I'm doing is sharing community information. Mm-hmm. To go into Facebook jail, for those of you guys that are my age and don't really know the parameters, all you got to do is say, I don't agree with this. Facebook doesn't have people like me and Sean sitting at a desk reviewing complaints or things. It's a computer bot, and all you got to do is say, this is pornography or you don't agree with it. You automatically go into Facebook jail for at least 7 days. And I've been in there for a long time. Thus, I'm going to ask you guys to like, share, and comment this show and share it yourself because I can't get into the groups. When you get banned, I can only share on the pages that I control. I can't share with any groups or anything like that. That's why you haven't seen me on Moreno Valley Matters mm-hmm. and all kinds of stuff like that. Everybody thinks that I'm gone, but I'm not. I'm still vigilant. I can see things, but I can't participate. So that's where we're at with that. Outside of that, Sean, we have what? The Patriots and the, I know you're not a football guy, and the Eagles playing. People are tired of seeing the Patriots in the Super Bowl, so hopefully the Eagles will win. I really don't want the Eagles to win because they're in the same division as my Cowboys, but I'd rather have the Eagles win versus the Patriots. It'll be the Eagles' first one. Patriots is going for number 5 Super Bowl. Let's see what else is going on. We are going to be trying to get a form together as people are pulling papers for election and get these candidates and introduce them to the public. Once we do that, we'll let you guys know where it's at, and we'll get that information out. And we're going to be hosting that for you guys. And we really want your input on that. And I want to say last time we were on the show, Sean, we had 14,336 downloads of our show. So people are listening to it. That doesn't necessarily mean it's all Moreno Valley or Inland Empire. It could be worldwide, but 14,000. So our message is getting out there. We just got to be consistent in how we do it. And we're not going anywhere. The key to success is consistency, and that's what we're going to be doing from here on out. Any other mental health news?
No, haven't heard much lately.
And again, it's still slow. It's the new year. Everybody's coming out, and when things warm up, we're going to get a little bit better. Next month, I'm going to be flying to Atlanta for the weekend, so it shouldn't affect our show. I'll be there for a day or two to see a friend of mine out there. And I don't go to Japan until May. I'll go back to my old high school and see some of my friends over there. And locally, any new businesses have opened up? Have you heard anything?
No.
Nothing at all opening up. So Moreno Valley is pretty much in trap. Tom DeSantis is the new city manager. He is a friend of mine, me and him are stationed at the base together over here at March. A lot of questionable things with Tom. He was ran out of Riverside and a couple other places. Again, that subject, I haven't seen anything that he's done so far yet, but we will be monitoring how Tom does the business of the city. I think the next city council meeting is this Tuesday coming up. I don't think it's a steady group. The last planning commission, because they didn't have a quorum, was canceled, so we got to deal with that. And another thing is, we have these groups that come out in these commissions, and people say, well, this isn't working, that isn't working. It's not working because not enough qualified people are applying. And so we get people like Rafael Gugueras and all these other people that don't know what the hell they're doing other than what Ito tells them, vote this way, do this or do that. And that's why we end up with some of the decisions that we end up with. Human trafficking here in Moreno Valley. This has been identified as a major human trafficking area on Sunnymead Boulevard. A lot of stings have been going on with that. And then
we've been talking about that for a couple of years now, that the choices that the city council has been making to what direction they want to see our economy was going to drive prostitution and drugs and whatnot.
Yes, truck drivers, a lot of trucks and stuff like that. But it's major here on Sunnymead Boulevard. And there was a DUI checkpoint last week. I can't remember the spot there was. So please be vigilant of that. Of course, Victoria Baca is against checkpoints. And she is still missing in action. So if you've seen Victoria Baca, please, please, please call the city and let them know you've seen her.
If she's been seeing District 1, she might be seeing at the Highland Fairview office. She might be seeing over in
If you
District
see her,
3.
Yeah, if you see her in District 1, please, please call us so we can report it because she is missing in action. And, of course, when she was the council person previously, she didn't give a damn. And she doesn't give a damn now. So she's concentrating on the Veragosa campaign as well as Idiot Gutierrez. Kid Kerberos has a hard election coming up. Please start looking at those 460s and the campaign trunk contributions. And it's going to tell you who is backing these people, as it always does, and it's always Highland Fairview. I think he's going to have a hard problem holding District 4 because people are, you know, a little bit more awake over there than they are in other areas. And then you guys are going to have a hard problem. We haven't identified the Highland Fairview candidate yet because nobody's pulled papers. And but we know Corey and Carla Thornton are going to have a – it's unfortunate. That's going to split a lot of votes in that district. And I just wish that they could, you know, come to a consensus to have one person behind them to – you know, we need to get behind one strong candidate in each district. So, but as far as the recall here in District 1, I haven't heard a damn thing. I haven't seen anything. And I'm going to tell you why the recall is not going to be successful, because the people that are doing the recall – they are 60 plus years old. Who is going to be out here walking and doing this now?
Plus, not, a lot of signatures are going to be having to be done during the summer.
They have to be done during the summer. And knock on wood, maybe Victoria, because she's already unpopular and not really liked here, she could be recalled anyway if they gather enough signatures. But let's not hold our breath. The question you got to ask yourself is, who do they plan to replace criminal Victoria Baca with? And that's the question. Jerry Mercado, if he's going to run, we don't know if he's going to run. I think he'd be a great candidate if he did. But outside of that, I can't see anybody else running. Chris Baca, no, I don't see him doing that. And if, even if he did, and let's say he won, I would still be kind of suspect of the Baca name. I just don't trust it. You know, so.
Brugaris.
Yeah, Bergeret, yeah, good thing he's not in this district, thank God. But, you know, people have asked me, you know, am I going to get involved? I'm not getting involved. I did it twice. I've done my civic duty. So, no, I'm not a candidate. Mm-hmm. And if you wanted me to be a candidate, you would have to write out a significant check for me to run, because I'm not going to do, you know, spend, you know, it does take a lot of time and effort and a lot of money, because we think about it. You're fighting $350,000 worth of Highland Fairview funding. And that's kind of hard for an average person to do, especially when people don't care. So that's where we're at with that. School-wise, Riverside Community College, or I'm sorry, Moreno Valley Community College, it was Riverside when I was a kid. Their new semester has started, I think it is. And, you know, we've got these kids out here running around and doing absolutely nothing but smoking weed. If you don't have anything to do, I would say get that paper, get that degree, because all these programs are being cut thanks to the new tax cut. And this is no shade to President Trump and the Republicans. People have had years to get their shit together. I'm not saying it's right. It is what it is. People are tired. So if you can't get your shit together now, I don't know when you're going to get your shit together. So, I mean, it is what it is. I mean, you know, I mean, I don't feel bad about him cutting the programs. If you don't want to take advantage of them, why do we have them? You know, and I don't think these programs should be made for people who aren't citizens.
Yeah.
You know, so if you agree or disagree, that's where we're at with that. Hindsight down the street, anything that you heard of in regards to Mark Takano?
Nope. Same old. I don't really see anything new coming from Mark Takano, really.
Right. I anticipate he will have a meet and greet coming up, as well as Jose Medina is going to be having a meet and greet. A lot of the politicians are going to start coming out of the woodworks and having these, you know, greet. And, you know, if you go on Twitter, go to the IE Informer, you're going to see a lot of California senators and assemblymen, you know, with, oh, I stood up for this, I stood up for DACA, I did this, you know, and it's just political grandstanding. But the whole point of what Sean does and what I do is to give you the information for you to make your own decision. Sean makes his own decision, I make my own decision, but at the end of the day, we're Americans first. He might be a Republican, I might be an independent. I am a registered independent, by the way. And it is what it is. No one idea is better than the other. You know, to me, I think it should be about what's best for the community. And Sean is here because he wants what's best for the community. I'm here because I want what's best for the community. How you go about it, that's a different way. And that's where the debate sparks. But without debate, you don't have any communication. If you can't communicate, then nothing gets done. Mm-hmm. So, and that's why we do this. Like I said, Sean doesn't have to come on the radio and show his face and do that. But we show our faces for those that want to know, who are these guys that are talking and telling us what's going on and how it's done or what we don't agree with. We want you to know who we are because we're not afraid, and we can't be afraid to voice our opinions about the direction we see our city going. And Sean's been here since you were a kid. Mm-hmm. Well, you've been here since you were like, what, five?
Yeah.
Good Lord. Whew. I've been here since I was seven, so I'm, you know, a couple more years more than you, but still, a lot of stuff going on. My last and final thing that I want to bring up, Moreno Valley Unified School District, I believe the Val Verde High School boys wrestling team just won a major tournament somewhere. I'm not sure if it was CIF or whatever, but I know that they won a major. I think they're state champions, by the way. So I guess that is CIF. So the Val Verde High School boys wrestling team is state champions, and that's another great thing. And that's a we have two school districts here. So, which I don't understand that, but okay. But Val Verde's one of them, and that's on the east side of the city.
It almost seems like Val Verde is an extension of Moreno Valley.
Yeah, yeah, kind of, but, you know, the east side wants their own thing, so I think that's why that was done there. And, kudos to those guys. They did a great job. I'm a big Moreno Valley Vikings booster, so it's right down the street from my house. I'm a big Vikings guy, and I love Canyon Springs, too. I remember that was being built. Any updates on the Canyon Springs stadium? Have they started construction at all?
Nothing I'm aware of.
Not too aware of.
I go to the store all the time, but mm-hmm. I'll have to drive up that way
and check it out.
Down Ironwood instead.
Yeah, because I'm not sure if there's any construction that's even started, but I know it was approved. Everything was mm-hmm. good to go, so that's good. A lot of noise that has been happening at the March Air Reserve Base. For those of you guys that don't know, a Air National Guard unit from South Dakota came out here because of the cold front that fell. And it was a serious cold front, and it was a training weekend. So they decided to come out to nice and sunny California and do a lot of their training out here, which also incorporated our guards and reserve men. And we used our tankers to help them. And it was a big training event. So if you heard a lot of fighter pilots and a lot of F-16 engines and whatever airplane it was a training exercise over at March Air Reserve Base. So no, the FEMA camps haven't started and the rounding up of people haven't started, but that's what was going on over there. And it's nothing really to be alarmed about. When you hear thunder in the valley, that's the sound of freedom. So you better be thankful that you hear it, because when you don't hear nothing going on at that base, that means a lot of these people have deployed and they're in harm's way. And we need to think about those guys at all times. And again, if you have a question of what's going on at your base, contact candidate Aja Smith. She's a reservist. She can tell you straight up and also tell you about what she plans to do when she becomes the next congressional representative in this area. So that's what's going on locally. Nothing else. Before I go, news from the Edgemont, which is our parent company here. Box Springs Water. You guys, I know a lot of you guys are familiar with the last scandal we had. There was a big embezzlement a couple years back, $580,000. The person that was in charge of it, she was going on casino trips, cruises. She was buying stuff, you know, just using the credit card up to $580,000. She did 5 years. She is out now. She's ordered to pay restitution and stuff, but we have a problem with that even right now with the current chairman that is on there. And we're going to stay on top of that. There's nothing concrete that we can say, but the $650,000 that was allotted when those apartments were built right across from the elementary school there, that money is gone. And we're talking wasted. Nothing for the shareholders. That money should have been in escrow and not needed, but mismanagement of the money. A lot of stuff is going on. Victoria Baca, the council person, is nowhere to be seen. We're going to stay on it.
What about the infrastructure?
The infrastructure is very questionable. Here's the problem. And I'm not a stakeholder, so it's hard for me to get information over there because it's a private company, so they can ask me to leave and whatever. So it's their thing. Here's the problem. It doesn't matter how wide of a pipe you get, low of a pipe or whatever, it has to deal with the pressure going through the pipe. Now, that water company is down to one pump. That pump was built in 1923, 28, or something like mm-hmm. that. Once that pump fails, because there are no more parts, because the parts have to be specially made because they don't make those things anymore, there will be no water pumping through those lines, mm-hmm. which means the city has to step in because it becomes a humanitarian crisis. And I've heard that they have a special contingency, something like that comes in, Western Water is going to come in and hook up their pipe and push everything through. But from what I hear, the piping that was used, a lot of the correct stuff that was supposed to be used was not used to standards. And we're going to have a lot of problems over there. But the $650,000 that the developer that did the apartments over there that was supposed to go in escrow, that money is now gone.
So the money is being embezzled or whatever they're doing. It looks to me, I'm just saying it looks like it's being embezzled somewhere, but I don't know that for a fact.
Well, when you have
this
a...
It doesn't look good.
Pressure. It doesn't look good at all because there was no reason for the $650,000 to even be touched mm-hmm. because you have a contractor that was part of the contract. Mm-hmm. So everything should have been provided by that contractor. But what this guy did is he had another... Why would you rent a backhoe or a bulldozer when the water company has two of them? Mm-hmm. That's what was working. They weren't new, but they were working. But they... This is his side guy that he's throwing money to.
Oh, him.
Yeah, and he would just give him money and say, okay, I'm going to rent your backhoe or your bulldozer for $300 a day. Mm-hmm. And so you do that for 10 weeks. That adds up and all these other things like this, and he's selling stuff. So, there's not much I can do but other than report on it, but do not be surprised that our tax dollars are going to have to go in there and rescue that water company.
I mean, what do you know about the contingency? I mean, because... If MWD has to come in, I mean, they can't do that in like 24 hours.
No, yeah, it won't be in 24 hours, but the
I don't see how they could do that within, it would probably take at least a couple of days. Really.
Yeah, it's going to take a couple of days, but in a contingency plan like that, they're going to have to give the local, I mean, who cares? It's just a bunch of illegal Mexicans over there and people who really can't afford anything. The dreads of society live in Edgemont, so nobody cares. That's why the area looks the way it does. Nobody gives a damn, right? So let them for 4 days without water, just give them some bottled water and good luck to them. Nobody cares. I mean, Victoria Baca, that's supposed to be her people. She doesn't give a damn. Because if that was my people, I would be damn sure make sure that they get the best that I can get them. Mm-hmm. But she doesn't give a damn. So for 4 days, 5 days, whatever it's going to take until they figure it out, these people are going to have to just deal with bottled water and however bypass they're going to have to do when they can get to it to do it. But it's going to take our tax dollars.
I mean, if you give them bottled water and porta cans, I mean, there's still going to be a problem with desperation and eventually unrest.
Absolutely. And guess what? We're coming to your neighborhood. So
yeah, that's exactly. That's what I said before. Yes. I mean, just because I live in District 2 doesn't right. mean that I'm removed from the issues of the rest of the city.
Right, exactly. We're going to be moving north and east. Yeah. So the good thing is I already live in Edgemont, so I don't have an issue here. So, but I am on the other water system, so I won't be affected by that. But the bottom line of the contingency is we are definitely going to have to step in because then it becomes a humanitarian issue. And the contingency is, I guess, Western Water Company is going to step in or whoever they're going to do. And they're going to have to buy the link or we're going to have to nationalize it for a little while and then take it from them, which is public domain it, and then do what we got to do. So because the city of Moreno Valley is not into owning water companies.
Yeah.
So that's probably what's going to happen.
I don't see how the city would ever get back because they're just going to do the same things over.
Yeah, exactly. And I don't see why the city can't own the water company. We already own electricity. So once we get it, we could just keep it and make money.
They don't actually have a power plant. They just broker electricity.
Yeah, we just broker. Well, we can still make a little something off of that.
Yeah, but in this case, they'd have to own the pumps and maintain the pumps.
Yeah.
They couldn't pass that buck off to someone else. So I don't see how the city would ever be able to take the water company back and run it themselves.
Yeah, and the problem with Edgemont is you've got people that have been there for 60, 70 years, and they're stuck into their way of thinking. It is going to take it would be cheaper to put a whole new pumping system in there. That would be cheaper across the board than trying to maintain they have.
And use a first-rate company that actually does this on a regular basis,
right,
up and is licensed, bonded, up to code, has a good track record and resume, all that stuff, has their own equipment so they don't have to go renting stuff from somewhere.
Right. But I think across the board, that would be the better thing but of course, when you do that, of course, your water rates are going to go up. Everybody's water's gone up. Sean's gone up. Mine's gone up. You can't stay in 1930 forever. You're going to have to upgrade, or you're going to be in a situation that you're in right now, which is going to cost us more money. And we've been telling you for years, you've got to upgrade these systems. But they won't do it. But that's the latest on that. I'll keep you guys posted the best I can. Very hard to get information there. Again, it is a private company for those that don't think it is. When it's a private company, there's really not much I can do other than report it.
If anyone listening actually has a stake in Box Springs Water,
and you want to put in a complaint or a...
Yeah, you're the ones that have access to all that information.
Yes.
We would love to know if there's actually embezzling or some other funny business or... What the heck is going on over there, and why nothing's?
Yeah.
Why the money's gone, and why there's no repairs to show for it?
Right, and then the chairman, Mr. Marks, it's alleged that he's being sued in the civil court. They're trying to serve him, and it's also been reported that the board for the water company has been dissolved because they have asked Mr. Marks to resign. And I've been trying to get the 411 on that, the information on that. And again, everybody's tight-lipped because only the owners really know what happened at the board meeting. Mm-hmm. Victoria Baca doesn't show up to the board meeting. LaDonna Jensen used to show up, but they asked him to resign. And when they asked him to resign, here's what happens when you go to the board meeting. And there's four or five of us over here, right? The minute you bring up asking me to resign, meeting adjourned, and that's it. Mm-hmm. I'm still the chairman. And so because of that, two or three of the board members quit of their own volition. So now they don't have a quorum. And this guy does pretty much whatever he needs to do as the chairman in absentee. So we're going to have a serious problem now. I alleged this four years ago.
That sounds like grounds for a lawsuit.
Yeah, but here's the problem. It's a private company. Nobody could sue but the people that are stockholders.
The stakeholders would have, it sounds like they would have grounds for a lawsuit if they would actually do it.
Absolutely. But here's the problem. Most of the original owners and stakeholders don't live in Edgemont. Because most of that place is running. There's only a few people that actually live there that are still there. And these people are like in their 90s and 80s. And no shade to our senior citizens, but some of them are at a point where they just don't give a damn right now. They're bedridden, or they ain't coming out of their home or whatever. But we're going to have a problem. I rang the alarm on this 4 years ago. Victoria Baca didn't give a damn. We gave $30,000 for her to gather a group of people. Didn't make sense. LaDonna Jimson.
A group of people for what?
For a meeting. And she, remember that her friend Kennedy? So $30,000 of our tax dollars went to this Kennedy lady because she was a consultant to gather people of Hispanic origin who can't speak English so that she could interpret the meeting to these people and what was going on with the water company. And these were mostly renters.
Do they even have a sufficient level of education to understand how that infrastructure works?
I doubt it. But Ms. Kennedy got our $30,000.
Well, I don't know why you have to go out of town to find someone that can interpret Spanish.
You tell me. Victoria Baca could speak Spanish, even if it's broken Spanish. So, but that's the problems that we have here in the city of Moreno Valley. So I'm going to stay on top of that as best I can. I live in Edgemont, so it's important to me because, again, when that pump goes out, these people are going to be going north up to Day Street and east on Alessandro, and it's going to be a major, major problem, and the city's going to have to step in at that point. So this has been the Hot Seat Radio Show. Sean, anything else going on this week?
Nope.
Not for you. How's everything with church and everything? Everything's going good?
Yeah,
your mentoring program is going good? You know, Sean likes to keep a low profile like you're supposed to in church. You don't have to highlight what you do and how you do it. But, you know, I think your mentoring is a great thing. You're involved in the community, and that's what it's about. So I don't want people to think that you're just sitting in your Republican cave with Monty Burns and all the Republican bigwigs making decisions. This guy actually has a heart. He's a Christ-based man, and I give him all the props for doing that. And we need a lot more mentors out there. I mentor when I can, so continue to do what you're doing. And I know you don't like to give a lot of praise, which is the way it's supposed to be, but sometimes you do need to say, hey, you're doing a great job. And the people that you're mentoring, or young man, young lady that you're mentoring, they are lucky to have you. So just don't indoctrinate them in the do what you want to do, but they're going to do that. Again, if you guys want to know what's going on in the city of Myrtle Valley, please, please, please look up. What's Gordon's page? MV Gordy. And that'll give you a history of what has been going on in the city of Myrtle Valley. Sorry about that, Gordon, for not. I just had a brain dump. Also, Stay Informed Myrtle Valley is another page. And Wake Up Moval, which is a page that was done by Audra Smith, but it has a history of what has been going on in the office. And also check us out here on the Hot Seat, as well as the Inland Empire Informer. Sean Fortine, Donovan Sadiq, again, Valentine's coming up. For those of you guys that have Valentine's, I'm telling you, get those chocolates. It makes a big difference. Real quick before we go, have you seen Star Wars, the Force, not the Force Awakens, the other one, the Last Jedi? Have you seen it?
Yeah.
What do you think?
I thought it was alright. I think it's pretty sure being a little too harsh on it. Not the best Star Wars, but I don't think it's that is
true. Right. I'm a Star Wars fan. I didn't care for the movie. And this is what I tell people. No matter what Star Wars they put out, it's going to make money. Because I'm a fan. I'm going to see it regardless.
Yeah.
I didn't think the movie was great. But, of course, I'm a Star Wars fan. I'm an original Star Wars fan. So, people are going to see it. They've got some bad reviews. But I wouldn't say it was terrible, but it wasn't good. So that's a one good thing. Solo is coming
out. I really did not like the Admiral Holdo character anymore.
Yeah.
Larger's done some good stuff in the past, and really wasn't much to work with.
Well, did you see the feminism that was in that movie?
Yeah.
It was, I mean, they don't even hide it anymore. It was blatant. Just in your face. You know, she knows it. No. Why won't you tell him the plan? Just tell him the plan.
Yeah, that's it. There was one guy a blogger who said something like a problem with the movie that was a 3.5 hour wreck caused by two female drivers.
Oh my god. And again, if you're into the feminist agenda, if you saw the movie, that's what it was. I mean, they were in your face. I mean, every white guy in the movie was a Nazi. No, nothing Nazi. I mean, it was sad. You know, the diversity.
Yeah,
I don't know.
The thing is that what Poe did save their butt, even
right,
though it caused a lot of casualties.
Right, but Finn and that one chick, that mission was useless. What was the point of that?
Oh, with Finn?
Yeah, with Finn, you know.
Yeah, if Admiral Holdo had just told Poe what was going on, then that would have been completely pointless.
Right, and then, you know, nothing against that girl. I think her name is Tran. Her last name is Tran. She's obviously Vietnamese or something like that. Mm-hmm. This diversity stuff, it just takes away from the story. Just tell the story. I don't care if you're black, white, whatever it is, but to reintroduce these characters because of you want to make a diversity quota is such bullcrap. I'm just not with that. So just tell the story.
That's picking people for diversity rather than talent.
Yeah, and that's what I saw in the movie, because her...
I just think your character was very good.
It wasn't necessary in the storyline. You're going to... Wait. Finn was going to kill him. Spoiler. Finn was going to kill himself for the resistance.
Yeah.
And then she stops him from making the ultimate sacrifice. It just didn't make sense. I was like, oh my God.
Yeah, because then a bunch of pilots got killed in the whole process of that mission too.
Oh my gosh, you guys. And we're going to start putting a couple of movie reviews and TV show reviews in here, because that's a good point, because it has a lot of political ramifications of what they did to that show. Stop politicizing these movies and just tell a story.
I'd like to see 12 Strong and Red Sparrow.
Red Sparrow.
That looks pretty good.
Right. One of my all-time favorite movies is Falcon and the Snowman. Timothy Hutton and Sean Penn, talking about those guys that sold Russian secrets in the 70s and stuff. It's based on a true story, and one of the guys is still in jail to this very day. But this has been the Hot Seat Radio Show every Thursday, 6, 7 o'clock. Sean Fortine to the right. I am to the left. I'm Donovan Sadiq. Check us out again next week. You guys have a great, great weekend. And don't forget, we have a meeting on Saturday, 1 to 2:30 p.m. at the Moreno Valley Golf Course, Moreno Valley Beach Drive and JFK. We'll see you guys there.